It's time to register to play our interactive game shows. Call 1-800-537-GAME. It's fast, it's fun, and it's free. You only have to register once to play forever on Game Show Network.
To you by Extra Rich Liquid Prel, the shampoo that leaves your hair lovely, alive, and shining. And now let's all play What's... And now, live from New York, for the 876th and last time, let's meet our What's My Line panel. First, making his 112th appearance as a guest panelist, the distinguished actor and producer, Mr. Martin Gable.
And on my left, a girl who's leaving next week for London to appear in a television special called Laura, Miss Arlene Francis.
And now a gentleman who has been a regular panelist on What's My Line. He's been an irregular panelist. He's always been a welcome panelist. And he has just authored a new book practically dedicated to this program called Bigger Than a Bread Box, Mr. Steve Allen.
And now I'd like to introduce one of the friendliest, most charming people I know, a distinguished publisher, lecturer, newspaper columnist, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
Well, as usual, it's my pleasure tonight, a rather rueful one, to introduce a gourmet, a bon vivant, and in every sense of the word, a gentleman. John Charles Day.
Thank you.
Well, Miss Arlene, 17 and a half years of Sunday nights, and you know it's a wonderful thing. Arlene grows lovelier every Sunday. Ah. And, Bennett, we have just come back from California, and I bring you a gift. Have you heard about the two hippies that were married in the bathtub?
No.
It was a double ring ceremony. And you don't know how hard it was to avoid the temptation, because I saw Bennett about 20 minutes ago for the first time since we parted for the month. And I just said, I've got to wait until we get out there. The one last pun, well, it won't be the last, but I hope one of the best will be mine. Well, Martin Gable has appeared with us over 100 times, more than any other guest panelist. And Steve Allen, as you all know, was with us for, a regular for a year and a half, and then many, many, many times as a guest. And we think it's a privilege that you two would join us and on this last program. And welcome
Thank
very
you,
much.
John. Thank you.
Now, we're going to have an occupation or two to solve tonight, and we'll have a mystery guest later on in the proceedings. But tonight's program is going to be a bit out of the ordinary, off the norm. To start things off, I'm going to ask three people to join us here on stage. Will you enter and sign in, please? Now, right here next to me is Pat Finch. The gentleman on your left is Arthur Feinberg. Next to him is Seymour Kolodny. Now, panel, not one of you was here That night when the first program of What's My Line appeared, in which these three people were the contestants in our very first show on February 2nd of 1950. Today, Mr. Feinberg.
Years old at that time.
Huh?
The girl was 8 years old at that time.
Very good. Well, Mr. Feinberg, we're going to start with, because we want to play a game, is an executive now of the same company that he was with in 1950. And, panel, I want to see if you can guess what he does. We'd admit it's just a wild guess. We'll give you one guess apiece. I'll tell you only that Mr. Feinberg has something to do with children. And we'll start with Arlene.
He makes baby carriages.
No. Mr. Allen?
He is in the diaper business.
Mr. Sir?
I thought he probably ran a diaper service.
Mr. Gable?
Makes bread boxes for children.
Mr. Allen and Mr. Surf both get one peppermint candy bar. They're both right, because that's exactly what Mr. Feinberg does. He's with the Cascade Diaper Service. Very good. All right. Well, Mr. Feinberg, all I can say is that I hope that the years have been as kind to you as they have been to What's My Life.
They have been, thank you very much.
You've enjoyed them as much as we have?
I have.
Well, and bless you.
I want to take this opportunity to wish you great success in your new undertaking.
Oh, thanks very much. And may you continue to prosper with the diaper business, because I think
with a population explosion, I
with a population explosion, yeah. Now, Mr. Kolodny is also engaged in the same occupation as he was when our first show went on the air, and I'll tell you that he is properly addressed as Dr. Kolodny. Now, let's start the guesses this time with Steve Allen.
I would guess he's a veterinarian.
Mr. Sir.
I think he's a dentist.
Mr. Gable.
Psychoanalyst.
Arlene.
Psychiatrist.
Mr. Allen gets another peppermint candy bar. Absolutely right. Dr. Kolodny practices veterinary medicine down in Greenwich Village. Well, Doctor, I know that it's been a long time since they had pasture down there. What have you been doing all of these 17 and a half years? Your clientele is what? Mostly
dogs and cats now.
Dogs and cats.
But the people are changing.
The people are
changing.
The dogs and cats go on.
Go on, but the people are changing.
And
yes.
the 17 and a half years have been kind to you, too, I hope.
Oh, yes, they have.
Oh, good. Well, it's with you, also, may I say we all appreciate your coming back to join us for the final show, having been with us on the first one.
Thank you.
Glad to have you both with us. All right, now, Pat Finch was the very first contestant on the first show, and thus the first occupation that any panel ever had to solve. Now, I'll tell you that in 1950, Pat worked for Sherman Billingsley at the famous Stork Club. And we'll start the guesses this time with Bennett Sir.
I would say she was probably the lovely girl who sold cigarettes there.
No, we want to know what Pat's doing now.
Oh, right. I thought you meant what she was doing.
Well, actually, I don't know. What do I want you to do? Yeah, go ahead. Do that.
Fine. I think she was a slender little girl peddling cigarettes at the store club.
All right, Mr. Gable.
Miss Finch is working at El Morocco now.
Miss Francis?
Well, I think Miss Finch should have graduated to her own bistro by now.
Mr. L.
My interpretation was the same as Bennett, so I'll guess what she did then. Since she's very pretty and doesn't look at all like one, I'll guess that she was a bouncer then or something of the sort.
Now, actually, Bennett was very close. Pat was the hat check girl at the Stork Club in those days. It's been torn down, as you all know, for Paley Park. But Pat Finch has gone on to bigger and better things. And, Miss Pat, suppose you tell us what you've gone on to.
Oh, well, Mr. Daly, I've been in several Broadway shows, some nice long runs among them, thank heaven. I stood by for Eileen Hurley in The Matchmaker and played the part, and I was in Fanny and Bells Are Ringing and Unthinkable Molly Brown. And now I'm doing television commercials and some television and radio.
That's
and
good.
I also have, just for the record, a very lovely 5-year-old son named Kenneth who's watching tonight.
Oh, wonderful, Pat. That's just grand. So there, that's, I hope in a way that having started with What's My Line was responsible for this rise in career that you've had. I know that I can say to Pat for you and to Mr. Feinberg and Dr. Kolodny. Thanks for being with us again as you were in 1950, 17 and a half years later. It was awfully good of you to come to our last show, and good luck to all three of you and the best of wishes and to that five-year-old, too.
The same to you.
Thanks, sir. We'll be back right after this word.
I love my hair in the sun. I love to see it gleam and feel the warm softness. That's why I pamper my hair with extra rich liquid Prel. Its luxurious lather leaves my hair lovely in the sun. And I feel beautiful all over.
Indulge yourself with luxurious liquid Prel. Not thin, sinfully rich. Liquid Pro.
I'd like to show you a little experiment. I'm cleaning the left side of this wax floor with a powdered cleaner. The right with Mr. Clean. Wet, both sides look shiny. But now's no time to judge a floor. Let it dry. See? Some of the powder that dissolved in the water dried back on the floor. Mr. Clean's side, still shiny. He leaves a sheen where he cleans. Get Mr. Clean, all right?
Well, so far on this last show, we've talked about the first show all the time. Before we leave that subject, we thought you'd like to see some 1950 television when instead of 56 million television sets, there were one-tenth of that number. Panel, we've got a big surprise, and I hope some fun for you, too. We've placed a monitor on stage for the first time. We're going to let you watch a part of What's My Line while it's actually on the air. Here is how, on February 2nd, 1950, a new program called What's My Line was introduced to a small but growing television audience.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to What's My Line. In fact, welcome to our premier telecast of What's My Line. And I certainly hope our distinguished panelists, members of our panel tonight, are going to do a fine job of human analysis. In other words, be able to answer the question, what's my line? Now, to start things rolling, I'd like the panel to meet our first challenger, whose occupation it's their job to ferret out. Will you sign in, please, miss?
Now watch Arlene, 1 month later, as she questioned a hotel house detective.
He gets up and down. He's not too sure what floor he's on.
No, that's right.
He's floored it.
Oh, dear me, I ought to penalize you for that.
Are there people employed in your organization that do the same kind of work you do?
Yes, ma'am.
Do you work, maybe it's a store. Oh, pardon me. Do you work on several floors of an organization or just on one?
Bennett Cerf made his premiere appearance with us on October 15th of that first year, 1950. Now famous for his long, complicated, and punny introductions, watch how he did the first time out.
And on my left, our guest panelist tonight, the famous publisher and columnist, Mr. Bennett Cerf.
And on my left is the famous news analyst and moderator and master of ceremonies of this program, Mr. John Daly.
Not a pun in a carload, then. Steve Allen joined us for the first time 1 year later in March of 1951. His wit and humor were apparent from the outset, as on that show, he questioned a challenger who made wedding rings.
Worn?
Yes.
Gee, I didn't expect to get this good so soon.
Go ahead.
I got it, but I don't know what to do with it. It's worn. Would it be, something you might see in a casual surroundings, like at the beach or something? Could it
yes.
be worn at the...
Yes.
You're doing great.
I know what you're thinking, and if you ask him if he models them, I'll throw the desk.
No, can be worn at the beach. Would it be all right to wear one of these and nothing else?
Head to the beach. Martin Gable came to us first, just in time for Christmas in 1956. sitting next to Mrs. Gable, as he is now, he questioned a lady who made nightcaps for bald-headed men.
Is it something that improves the general well-being of the male sex, that portion of the sex that uses it?
I think it might.
Is it something that I would be apt to want to buy for myself?
You might.
Is it something which, when I applied it in whatever form, would improve me in some way?
Well, I'm not going to answer that one. I'll say that. Well, these have been wonderful years, and I might say I think the finest thing about it are the close bonds of friendship that have been formed by all of us who are the old hands on What's My Line, and we can take much comfort in the simple fact that these friendships will continue in the years ahead. The 17 and a half years have brought us sadness, too. Two of our oldest and dearest friends left us, Dorothy Kilgallen, who was on the very first program and was with us for 15 years, Fred Allen, who was with us for better than a year and then went on, too. And I would say only, speaking for the panel and for myself, that we all treasure the memory of those years when they were with us. Now, very soon, panel, we're going to get back to what we've done for 17 and a half years. We're going to have an occupation for you to guess. We'll give you that chance right after this message.
Here's a pleasant surprise for people with indigestion or heartburn. New Pepto-Bismol tablets. They work two ways. One, they neutralize excess stomach acid for fast relief. Two, their coating action protects your stomach lining against excess acid for prolonged soothing relief. Get both, acid neutralizer and stomach coating action. Carry good-tasting, chewable pink Pepto-Bismol tablets.
Think. 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 Think of all the things in your home that can burn you.
Ouch!
That's why it's good to keep a reliable friend on hand, unguentine. Unguentine has, well, it has a long name and does a fast job, cools burning pain. You unburn with unguentine for fast temporary relief. Do you have unguentine in your home?
Ouch!
After all, you never know when you might need it.
All right, and now let's see what we can do with the regular challenger. Would you enter and sign in, please? L. Fergieli, right there? Mr. Fergieli, where are you from?
New York City.
New York City. May I present the panel, sir? Fergieli. Now, if you'll join me over here, we'll let the audience at home and the audience in the theater know exactly what your line is. Panel, we can tell you that Mr. Fergieli is salaried and deals in a service, and we'll start things with Arlene Frank.
Well, Mr. Fergieli, you're handsome enough to be a performer yourself. Do you perform in any way?
No.
One down and nine to go, Mr. Allen.
Are your services equally of interest to men and women? Of you?
Yes.
Does what you do change them physically in any way?
No.
Two down and eight to go, Mr. Sir.
Have you any connection whatever with the entertainment industry?
No, I don't.
Three down and seven to go, Mr. Gable.
Have you anything to do with clothes?
No.
Four down and six to go, Miss Francis.
Would people come to you for your service?
Yes.
Would I hand the money directly to you for the service that you might give to me?
No.
Five down and five to go, Mr. Allen.
When you are performing your professional function, are you attired differently than you are at this moment?
No.
Six down and four to go, Mr. Sir.
Do you work for a profit-making organization?
No.
Oh, I'm going to throw all the cards over. We're just trying to give you a service, That's all, I mean, Mr. Fergieli.
He runs a service.
That's right. He handles claims for the New York State Unemployment Bureau.
That's funny.
Mr. Pergelli, we had you here because we all wanted to meet you. You know, I was going to say.
What are your hours, Mr. Pergelli?
I was going to say, I hope that you have a long and busy career ahead of you, but I don't really mean that because I don't want you to be that busy.
Well, we, you know, the kind of service we perform is very rewarding in many ways, and we, of course, don't expect to see any of the panel
we'll
in
be
there.
To
I hope you don't either.
We'll
thanks
you.
Very much, sir, for being part of our show. Nice to see you. We'll be back with our final mystery guest in just a moment.
Denture wearers are asking, is there a difference in denture cleansers? Listen to what Mr. David Kerman, a denture wearer, has to say.
You know, since I've been using Polident tablets, my dentures are really clean. Odor-free, too.
Polident, a revolutionary tablet that really fights denture stain and odor with an exclusive combination of active cleansing ingredients and effervescent oxygen action. See this bar of denture material? It's covered with tough food stain. Drop it into warm water with a Polident effervescent tablet, and instantly, the power-packed oxygen whiteners start to clean. Scrub stain and odor away safely, in minutes. Your dentures are cleaner, fresher tasting. Is there really a difference in denture cleansers? Remember what Mr. Kerman says.
There's just nothing like Polident tablets. It's the best way I know to clean dentures.
And now we come to the special feature of our program, the appearance of our mystery challenger, which, as you all know, the panel is always blindfolded. Are the blindfolds all in place, panel?
Yes.
Good. Will you come out, mystery challenger, and sign in, please? As you know, panel, in this case, a different form of questioning, one question at a time, in turn, moving clockwise, and we will begin with Martin Gable.
Are you in the theatrical business? Thank you, John.
No.
That's one down and nine to go. Arlene.
Are you voted into office?
No.
That's two down and eight to go. Mr. Allen.
Have you any connection with the world of sports?
No.
What? No. That's three down and seven to go, Mr. Sir.
I smell eight rats. Have you any connection with the television industry?
Yes.
Mr. Gable?
Are you connected with this network?
Yes.
Arlene?
Are you going to be out of business like the rest of us?
Arlene, do you have something in mind that, I mean, you want to take a guess?
Well, if it's anybody I think it is, they won't be out of business as much as I will. But I just want to keep in good with them. Is it by any chance Mark Goodson and Bill Todman and part of the show? No.
No.
Four down and six to go. Mr. Allen.
Oh, dear. I thought it was Goodson and Todman. Yeah. Or Donder and Blitzen or somebody like that. Now I'm at a loss.
You did say connected with the network.
Yes.
Yes.
Are you having any fun? No. Are you a senior officer of this network?
No.
Now that's five down and five to go, Mr. Sir.
Are you possibly impersonating yourself, Mr. Daly?
No, I.
Who? I hadn't realized how hard that was. I'm practically out of voice.
Crazy about your new voice. That's the voice of America.
You think I've got a future, do you, Arlene? Well, let me explain very quickly that we did that because, although I suppose it's difficult for you all to believe it, we've had literally thousands of letters in 17 and a half years saying, why don't you be the mystery guest? We've never been able to use it. because it was the only backstop we had in case a mystery guest didn't come. Because the mystery guest arrives after the program starts, and we've had a couple of close shaves, 1 minute once before, yes. Before the guest was supposed to go on. Well, I see our time is running short, so I think what we had better do is something we'd all want to do. One last task remains, a happy task. I'd like to bring out the two men responsible for the creation of What's My Line, and through it for the panel game show as a television staple, Mark Woodson and Bill Totten.
John, that was one of the funniest mystery guest spots I've ever heard.
Hilarious.
You know, it seems almost impossible to realize that Sunday night at 10:30 will not be What's My Line time anymore. We've been around so long, we've become more than a show, I think. We've become kind of an institution, sort of. Even those who didn't tune us in regularly every week knew we were there, like the Plaza Hotel and the Lions in front of the library. And I was just realizing when I saw the diaper service man out here and someone talked about the growth in population, that since What's My Line has been on the air, some over 70 million children have been born in the United States. And incidentally, Twiggy was 6 months old when the show went on the air. We've had a marvelous roster of guests, and I couldn't possibly read them all off now, but it will not be the same without What's My Line. We're going to miss it, and we're going to miss you, too. Bill?
Thank you, Marcus. William, you have a word.
I feel like crying, but I won't. I would like to thank, most sincerely, for all of us, to our wonderful CBS crew, the technicians, too numerous to mention. I want to thank Gil Fates, our producer, who has been with us since our very first show, Franklin Heller, our director, who started on our very third program, Ann Krieger and Bob Bach, each with us from the beginning, and Ann Krieger for 13 of those years, Barbara Griff, the program staff, and from all of us to all of you out there, we thank you for being our audience. Good night.
And now, Johnny Olson, come in here. Johnny Olson, come in and be a part of the gang. And as we say good night, because it is time to say good night, Johnny Olson here, who's been with us for all these years. Goodbye, Marty.
Thank you. Bye, Johnny. Thank you.
I've enjoyed it very much. Good luck to us all.
20 seconds is a very short time after 17 and a half years to say goodbye to all of our friends. My feelings are too deep to make up for that ratio in time. But thank you all deeply, and very good luck to our replacement.
Arlene, you took the words right out of my mouth. Good night. Good night.
Well, this is the end of one of the most rewarding, wonderful experiences in my life. I've enjoyed every minute of it. And I hope a lot of you who watched this have enjoyed it, too. Thank you for supporting us. And, John, I hope you're going to be a beautiful voice of America.
Thank
you.
Good night. Thank you, Bennett. Good night, ladies and gentlemen, for having been with us for 17 and a half years with What's My Line.
What's My Line was brought to you tonight by New Collagen Tablets, the powerful new dental cleanser tablets to keep your breath fresh, keep your smile bright and natural.
On VertaVision presents Surveys and Polls Monday.
Now, we don't have time to play our regular tiebreaker, so we'll play sudden death. Now, here's the way it goes. The first one even to score a match will be the winner. We have one tiebreaking question for both of you. You'll be playing with our three regulars, Brett, Charles, and Richard. And for this, you, the two of you, that is, will write your answers, and the celebrities will not write. You will give us verbal responses. Ready? All right, here we go. Blank leaf. L-E-A-F. Put it in there facing you so that you can read it. Yes. All right. Now we'll call on our regulars one at a time. All right. Are you ready? Blank leaf.
Fig leaf.
Fig leaf. Have we got a winner there?
No, we don't. Charles, what do you say?
Maple.
Have we got a winner there?
No, maple leaf. Blank Leaf, L-E-A-F.
Green Leaf.
Green Leaf, we've got a winner!
Well, first with $10,000! We'll sign up tomorrow as we give you Hurl of Business!
Gonna shake his hand there. Thank you for being with us. Buck Rogers, ladies and gentlemen.
Herd of Vision tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. Eastern, 7 a.m. Pacific, with surveys on Mondays.
In 1950, the phrase rock and roll had yet to be coined. Harry Truman was in the White House. The average annual income was $3,200 a year. In 1950, a brand new car ran you $1,500, while gasoline was 25 cents a gallon. Also in 1950, America started watching What's My Line. Times certainly have changed, but you can still watch What's My Line every weeknight on Game Show Network.
Your television is starting a brand new career on Game Show Network. Discover jobs you never knew existed. And jobs you could only dream of.
Well, when it's worn, does a lot of skin show?
I think when it's worn, a lot of skin shows, don't you?
See celebrities before they got really sweet film deals.
Are you part of the entertainment world?
Yes.
We miss you.
Oh, yeah.
And get in on the games as guests try to stump the panel.
You know, I have a delicious feeling all over me that I know who this is. Well, I was a rousing reception. Is this a beautiful woman?
That would be one down and nine to go.
Get in on What's My Line? Weeknights on Prime Games, 10:20-ish Eastern, 7:20-ish Pacific.
Attention home viewers, here comes an important announcement.
Is it in any way educational?
No, it's fun. What's My Line is now on Game Show Network 5 nights a week.
How about that?
Witness brilliant lines of questioning.
Are you a married lady?
Discover unusual lines of work.
Could I use your services?
And succeed in making yourself a happy home viewer.
Oh, really? You mean I could fail at it?
Only if you miss What's My Line, weeknights at 11 on Game Show Network.